All right, I'm about to show you the circle of fifths formula in less than 10 minutes. All right, I'm going to show you the easy way to do it. What I usually do is I start off with the center. These are 12 different notes, starting with like a clock. So C would be 12, A would be 3, the F sharp G flat would be 6, and the E flat would be the 9. So what I do is I can start off with just C and just work the outer notes all the way around. All you got to do is count from 5, from C to E. C, A, B, C, excuse me, C, E, F, G. What is it? Come on, I'm tripping. C, E, F, G. What am I tripping on? Man, I must be really tripping. C, D, E, F, G. Wow, I don't know what happened there. But anyway, the G is a fifth away from C. This is dealing with the white keys. So you go C, D, E, F, G. And then from the G, G, A, B, C, D. D, E, what is it? D, E, F, G, A. And you go all the way around and you fill out all the different notes. And you'll end up right back at C. From F to C, from F to C is 5. So F, G, A, B, C. So if you end up with C, then you did it correctly. Then you can do the inner circle, which is the minor. The A is the 6 of C. So once you type, once you write A minor right there, that's the 6 of C. Then you can do the same formula. A, B, C, D, E. E, F, G, A, B. B, C, D, E, F, right? So these are your sharps. So you start writing your sharps here, F sharp, C sharp. This is your sharp side on the right side. See? That's enormic. That means it has two different note names. And then this is your flat side. So all the notes over here, the D flat, the A flat, the E flat, and the B flat. So you can type out the actual sharps and flats in each key if you want to, but I just gave a numeric value. So there's no sharps or flats in the key of C. There is one sharp in the key of G. There is 2 in D, 3, 4, 5, and 6. In the key of F, there's one sharp. B flat 2, E flat 3, A flat 4, D flat 5. Now, if you wanted to actually just put the actual notes, then you can realize that there's no sharp. F is not sharp. D is not sharp, so that's why it's 0. But then when you go to, let's say, the next one, G, you use this diagram. So it would be these sets of 6 numbers. If we were doing G, then these would be your keys, your notes in that key. These are the notes in that key. So notice how I showed you here, right? So we have F, C, and G, and then D, A, and E. So the C is the 1, so that's the first note in the key. So, you know, you can go all the way around. That's the first note in the key. Then you go to the 2. Then you go to the 3. The E is the 3rd of C. And then you can go to the 4. F is the 4. And then you can go to the 5, which is on the right. And then the middle, like I said, that's the 6. Now, the way you get your 7, because there's 7 notes, it's going to end up being B, which is right here. So then you can count over 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that's why that turns out the way it does. That becomes your diminished. So that's how you can get to the 7. That works for any of these keys. So you see how you have a 3 there? If you move it, continue, and you did your G, it would be these sets of notes for the key of G. So this would be the 1, excuse me, this would be the 1, that would be the 2, that would be the 3, that's the 4, that's the 5, and that's the 6. And if you count over, so far, it has 1 sharp, and I already know by heart what it is, but if you count over 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that's G sharp or F sharp. That is the 1 sharp that's in the key of G. You can do that for every key. If you did that for D, then it says that it's 2 sharps. Then F sharp is 1 of them. And then if you count over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. D flat is the same as C sharp. So that's your 2, F sharp and C sharp. That's the 2 that goes with the D. And you could just work your way all the way around if you wanted to actually type out and write out what those flats and what those sharps are. And I just gave you the circle of fifths. There's other ways that you can use this. You can use it to figure out what key you want to go to if you want to change the song to a bridge or change. And the further away you move from the center of your key, the more harder the change will be. So you can go from a C to a G easily. You can go from a C to a D easily. You can go to a C to an A easily, but it gets harder and harder, and then the change will be more abrupt. But so obviously you can go from C to a 4, and you can go from a C to like a 7 or a 7 flat. But then when you start going further and further, it becomes harder and harder to make that transition. So those are a few ways to actually use the circle of fifths. But to actually fill it out, every note is really a fourth away. It's called a cycle of fifths or a cycle of fourths, but we call it a circle of fifths or circle of fourths. So basically from C to G, numerically, that's 5, right? But it's really 4 if you don't count the C. So if you go D, E, F, G, then that's 4. So I always count the note that you're on, and then you'll get 5 all the way around, so you never make a mistake. C, D, E, F, G. And if you use it that way, if you do it that way, you'll never make a mistake. Yeah, you could do it using 4, but remember, you can't count the key. And that works for the inside. Now, you can also go counterclockwise if you want to. And some people memorize the notes. You can make a mistake if you do it that way. The way that I do it is I count all the way around. But if you can memorize it and come up with these acronyms, I'm not a fan of acronyms. But if you can remember an acronym for all of these, then you can use that. But the way that I just showed you is a foolproof way to get the outer notes and to get the inner notes. And the inner notes are the minor. And I guess you can say that the outer notes are not necessarily the major, but they are the white keys. Those are the white notes. And this is how you do the circle of fifths within 10 minutes. Oh, one more thing before I let you go. So I put the key of the C right here so you can put it in order, because right now that's not in order. So I put it in order to show you that C is the 1, D is the 2, E is the 3, F is the 4, G is 5, the A is the minor 6, the B is the 7, and a C can be considered, the next C is the octave. So from C to C is octave.